Hello, everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and we are back with another episode of Pokémon HeartGold. In the last episode, we caught Flutterby. Let me see if I actually have her out right now. I do, but I have to deposit Agent Spooner. So I did some running around and stuff, and I did some adjusting to some fangs, and it was a tough decision, but I decided to activate a cheat to get some rare candies and get everyone caught up. just because it's a fast forward for you guys doesn't mean it can't be a fast forward for me as well. I basically just did it so that everyone could at least get caught up to the point where they're manageable levels. Like, I wanted to make sure that I wasn't missing out on some progress, because there is always that charm of raising up your Pokemon from nothing. So I've gotten pretty much everyone up to level 40. So, like, they're still, like, 10 levels behind what they probably should be. But, they're definitely stronger than they were before, and, yeah, as we can see, still plenty strong. Man, look at Miyagi, man. Miyagi's friggin' good. But yeah, I made sure that everyone was manageable. I got Flutterby down a little bit further just because she's still new to the team and stuff. Still have the experience share attached. So, I wanted to sort of nail a balance there. And, I wanted to just make sure to pull this along a bit more. Because a lot of what it's been since we got into Kanto was just fight, die, fight, die, fight, die, right? Blacking out a lot, so I'm hoping that this is better. And again, that's not even the focus of this episode. I just wanted to tell you guys that's how things are going for right now. And whoop, there we go. Sorry, I was just doing some adjusting here. There we go. I wanted to show you guys what the trainer house was, and the trainer house is actually really friggin' cool. It's a place that you can go to. It was kind of like what mixing records was before you were able to mix records in Ruby and Sapphire. And basically, what the trainer house is you can receive battle information from trainers that you've linked up through Mystery Gift with. That's pretty much how it works. So I'll go over here. The newest and most happening place in Viridian. Yep. You can battle against the best and of the best right downstairs. So the cool thing about this place is that there's like one default trainer that always appears, and I think you can battle him every day. I think that's how it works. Once a day you can battle this guy if you haven't mixed records with anybody through Mystery Gift. Because if you do, then you inherit their team information and you basically battle somebody else without actually being beside them, like linked up with a link cable. That's the way it worked in the original games, at least. And yeah, so this lady's probably gonna explain it. Right, in the remakes it wasn't a Mystery Gift, it was Pokewalkers. That's what it was. If you link your Pokewalkers with somebody else, you were able to... Here we go, just gotta... Would you like to train yourself? Sure. yeah, you were able to obtain their trainer information. So then once it gets exported back via your Pokewalker, you can friggin' go and battle their trainer and your Pokemon. It's friggin' cool. I like it. I always liked that part of Ruby and Sapphire when you could link up with people and then it'd be like, oh, hey, look, they're just hanging out in their base. Because then you could see their decorating skills. You could see what song they tried to put together on the music notepads. But anyway, here we go. Alright. I would reset the emulator right now because it is like lagging a little bit on the overworld, but I'm actually like super strapped for time right now. I want to make sure you guys get a video of this today. So I'm kind of rushing here. But this is actually going to be a pretty intense battle. I might not win this because this guy's pretty strong, dude. Yeah, dude, let's battle. I believe his name's Cal. And his team, again, like in the originals, like I was alluding to, it's the fully evolved forms of the Johto starter trio. But they all have much better movesets than they did in the original. Oh, interesting. We all get booted down to 50? Is that how it works? Snap, it is. Oh, interesting. Because Michelle Ruff's supposed to be level 51 right now. Okay, alright. So this Meganium... I'm trying to recall its moveset. Poison Powder... No, not Poison Powder. Toxic. Toxic, Protect, Leech Seed, and... Solar some grass attack, I think. Maybe it might actually be synthesis. But anyway, the one fortunate part about this Meganium is that it can't really do anything to us besides badly poison us. And even then, I can just, it's kind of just like a really cheap Toxistall kind of set. So it's like, it's not too much to worry about. Because all we can really do is, oh, nice. Oh, Energy Ball, that's the other move. Okay, cool. Here we go, so I can probably take another one of those toxic hits. There we go, all right. This thing's actually, oh, items can't be used. Oh, good. All right, good then. Alright, so you're probably just going to use Energy Ball again, I take it. Yeah, alright. And we're going to die from Toxic, but that's okay. So let's think here. Grass type. Poison. Poison's the dealio. So I'm trying to think of what would be best to use against this Meganium. Something that would be weak to, but I actually don't think I have anything that's, like, good against it. I have Flutterby. Times 4 resisting Energy Ball. Flutterby might actually be able to do something here. Let's see if we can like get a supersonic off on him or something. Oh no, you're gonna go for the Leech Seed. What a son of a gun. Okay, I see what you're doing. What an annoying Meganium. And I missed again. I thought I had Compound Eyes, dude. Come on. Good lord, I should have like 70 accuracy on this. Ugh. There we go. All right. There we go. That's what I wanted to happen. I was going to try and get a Silver Wind off on it. But now might be the time for... I have no idea. We're obviously not going to win this because I didn't realize that you couldn't use items. But this is still a really cool way of demoing the trainer house because it's super cool. And this is a super tough fight too. That's kind of what I like about it. Just a tough as nails sort of battle, you know? I can dig it, man. Are we going to win with Trojan? Probably not. If only I taught Trojan like a poison move or something, I could let conversion turn me into a poison type. That would have been nice. Here we go. I don't friggin' know, I'm just messing around now. Energy Ball, yeah. Well, I wanted to show off the other two Pokemon in this battle, but I didn't realize that they were just gonna kick the stuffing out of me. But, here, let's go for Flutterby again, actually. I just want to see what Silver Wind will do. It probably won't do crap, but still. Oh, no, you're fine. Yeah, just protect yourself. That's fine. All right. Nice. Good. Yeah, look at that. That does, like, nothing. Wow. Here, let's get another one off. Yes! Oh, my stats rose! I might actually survive another Silver or Energy Ball. Flutterby, you are a trooper, man. Let's go for another Silver Wind. There we go. Let's get him to use up that citrus berry. Why don't we? Anyway, his other two Pokemon obviously are the Typhlosion and a Feraligatr. And Typhlosion has like a substitute set. I think it's like Substitute, Flamethrower, Eruption, and Focus Blast, I think that's what it is. And Feraligatr is actually like a pretty friggin' good set. It's, Feraligatr is Crunch, Dragon Dance, Ice Fang, and Waterfall, maybe? Or Aqua Tail, or something like that? Something along those lines, at least. There we go, yeah! Yeah, use that Citrus Berry! Friggin' right. Alright, let's see what Triple Kick does. Oh, okay, well, it's just gonna miss. And now I'm badly poisoned. Let's try it. Let's demo it. This Protect is really starting to piss me off. When are you just gonna run out? When are you gonna run out forever? Oh, well, now we're seated. What a tough son of a gun. If I just had, like, one Pokemon that was around its level and could exploit a weakness, I'd have this in the bag. Like, if Flutterby was level 40 instead of 30, I probably could have won. But, oh well, whatever. I wanted to fight against the Feraligatr. I wanted to see how strong that thing was. Because it has Dragon Dance. I wanted to see what would happen once it got a Dragon Dance off. But anyway, it's still good. I just wanted to get this fight shown off. Oh my god, we might actually... No, come on! No! Iggy! Iggy, you're so good, man. There we go. Nice. All right. I don't think I can KO it with extreme speed, so I might have to come on now. There we go. All right. Nice. Critical hit. All right. Now we finally get to see Typhlosion. Or no, he's gonna send out Feraligatr. Why wouldn't you? Oh, Ice Punch! Oh snap, that's even worse! Well, there we go. That's alright though, I just wanted to demo that. That's always nice. Victory! Thank you! Yeah, no problem. It was all part of my plan. Yeah. Sure, we'll come back. I want to make that a goal now. Cal is like our new second rival, dude. We're gonna come back when we're stronger, and we're gonna beat the pants off of that guy. We'll even go 3-on-3 against him to make it fair. For him! Haha. Because we're totally gonna beat him. Alright. So, we've gotta advance, man. There's actually another battle I wanna get done. Again, whether or not we'll actually win this battle, I have no idea. But I kinda wanna do it. I kinda just really wanna do it. So let's get who do I want? I guess I want Elmer, I guess. For cut. Yeah, perfect. We got advance in Kanto, because we just beat Brock, of course. We've got to get on moving over to Misty through Mount Moon, because we're going through this the canon way now. Now that we have access to all of Kanto, we might as well do it the way it was originally intended, right? Let's get on our bike in our lovely 15-frame world here. All right, I want to see what that item is, too. I believe we find a very useful item that I'm waiting for on this route, so I think this is actually it right here. Oh, it's not, though. What? I know that we're able to find a... we're supposed to be able to find a big route on Route 3, unless I already found it and I just didn't realize. Which is highly probable. Let me just see here. Mm-mm-mm. Oh, but I didn't. Okay. Alright. I've still got one heart scale left over, too, for when Michelle Ruff evolves. Because if you guys didn't notice during those fights, I did find a couple more heart scales and retaught Dragonair, like Aqua Tail, and I retaught Sleep Powder to Flutterby and stuff like that. Just like little things, you know? Oh, here's the big root. This must be it up here. No? Where the hell is it? Is it invisible? It must be an invisible item. I want the big root, man. That's the item I'm looking for. I need it for my Flutterby, man. Let's see. Maybe it's in this house. Oh, my good nuggets. You're the first visitor I've had. Okay, well, thanks for the nugget. Thanks. Did I pick up... Wait a second. I saw like one of the professor aides down here. Let me just see here. I've got an idea about a little something. Looking for you in his lab. Oh, okay. Thank you for the sacred ash. Alright. I think I collected all this stuff before, but a crash must have happened, I think, so. That's interesting, though. I wonder where that big root is. I'll have to do some more searching in time for the next episode. I'm just in a rush to get this one done because of, what am I trying to say? Oh, there we go. I'm in a rush because I'm about to go to work, so. I just want to squeeze one out before I head on out. So let's, get on here and go biking. Here we go. Whoa. Alright, so I fought all these trainers before, so I don't need to worry about these guys anymore. As we can see. There's an item over there. What is that? What is that all about? I want that, whatever that is. Alright, where's my super repels? I already know where it is, man. It can't escape me now. Maybe I misread it. Maybe it was Route 4 you find it on. Maybe this is it over here. Zibigurut. It is too! Oh my god! I did misread it. And that's exactly what I was looking for. Perfect. Alright. Wonderful. So let's see, no, don't go over to the little medicine cabinet there. Go on over to the big root, and give it to Flutterby. Yeah. It's alright, we don't have to worry about the experience share. Flutterby's gotten to the point where she can probably fend for herself if we pick the right opponents, so I'm not too worried about her. Not as much as I was with, like, Trojan and Miyagi, because they just had kind of weak moves, you know? Whereas I've already got most of Flutterby's core moveset built, so not as worried on that front. Okay, I'm trying to think here. We've got another important battle, man, coming up. Actually, like just now, actually. So I might throw you in front. Is he the best choice? I have no idea. But hey, let's find out. Cause I did not expect this when I first, like, when I first played this game so many years back. And when I went into Mount Moon for the first time, I did not expect this at all. Check it. Check this out. What the heck, Dinkles, man? What are you doing here? Hey, Will! You're here in Kanto 2. Some of the trainers here are tough, which makes it easy to train my Pokémon. Will! I know that you are strong, but I can't help but challenge you! I'm addicted to challenging you! I have one more battle, and I just think that's it, but then I just need another hit. I can't help it. Well, anyway. His team is strong, as you can see. But maybe, just maybe, not quite strong enough. Now, oh, interesting. The one time I've seen inner focus being useful. Trying to get a fake out off. But that's fine, because we have Rock Slide, so that will not hold us back for very long. Are you kidding me? Are you actually kidding me right now? Oh my god. Like, just a tiny little bit of health left. You've got to be joking. Whatever. Get the Shadow Claw. I don't care. Whatever. Is that, like, the only move he has that's, like, good? It must be. Anyway. Anyway, meanwhile. Alakazam, huh? Huh. Let's see what we can do against that. Because there's not much here. Elmer, get out there. I have a feeling I'm probably just going to lose again. But, hey, you know what? That's fine. Poor Elmer. Poor girl. Oh well. Let's see. Iggy. I'm thinking probably Michelle Ruff. We might be able to bait out Typhlosion with this too. So let's just see. Let's see what we can do here. Yeah, we'll go for Body Slam. Psychic. Hits hard, but not quite enough for a two-hit. KO. And I've got just barely enough for a two-hit KO, but he's going to set up Reflect. Ah, oh, what a douche. Yeah, get out of here with that disable. Ugh. Here we go, in case he tries to go for it again. I figured he was going to. Nice. He didn't lock me up that time. Hehe. I feel like he pulled that exact same trick on me, but I might be recalling something wrong. Like, I was just about to KO him with Michelle Ruff, and, like, he just breaks out. Ooh. And then he just breaks out the disable at the last second. I feel like he's done that before. Ticks me off. Frig, dude. I don't know if I can switch in Trojan that safely. Because I know he's going to go for the poison attack. Or, okay, or the flying attack. Alright, I guess it could have gone either way right there. Let's go for the conversion. Oh, come on. Oh, God. Okay. Alright, opponents, Reflect wore off. A Stab Discharge should do us well. That should do wonders. Nice. Alright. Let's see what we can do here. Shouldn't quite kill me. Oh, well, it did. Okay, well. I guess I should have figured that. I mean, Poison Fang and Air Cutter are like the exact same amount of power, pretty much. Should have saw that coming. Let's try Miyagi here. I shouldn't have done that because he's just gonna go for Air Cutter, and if I try going for the fake out, I think he has Inner Focus, doesn't he? That's friggin'. Why do you have two Pokemon with Inner Focus? Oh, what a jerk. I don't know, let's go for it. At least we get the priority. Yeah. Friggin' two Pokemon with Inner Focus. Like, the most useless ability in almost any situation. And it's like the reason I'm losing right now. Whatever. We can probably finish him off with an extreme speed. Maybe. Even then, we might not. Oh, come on. Come on. There we go. I don't even care if I'm badly poisoned, because I'll probably just shake it off with Shed Skin. Alright. Good. Good. Good for you, Dinkles. He is actually doing quite well. I have to give him credit. Okay, Gengar. Gengar, huh? Let's see. Let's get Trojan back up here. Let's get him back on his feet. Shadow Ball. So I'm trying to think of what Gengar's moveset might be right now. He's got the Shadow Ball, obviously, but Trojan's typing will definitely disarm that danger. Mean look, okay. Gives me time to recover. Nice. We might actually be walling him right now. I have no idea, honestly, but we might be walling him. Or Confuse Ray. Does he seriously have nothing to hit us with? Because if I break through this and hit him with Psybeam, I think he's pretty much done. Oh, you. It's always like, it's always just like a little bit too little. This whole fight, that's what it's been. Oh, the worst. Just the worst. Alright, break out of my confusion. Okay. Still didn't break out of it, but hey, at least we killed him. Ooh, yeah, look at that. We got all that experience before we fainted. We're really holding up well, I'm surprised. Let's see. Especially for being, like, way under-leveled right now. Typhlosion, figured. Alright. Let's see here. I know he's just gonna go right for the, whatever he's gonna go for. I'm actually not sure what he's gonna go for, but... let's see. I have no idea. I'm probably wasting this max revive, but... Iggy's really the only guy that's got the good shot against him. Flame Wheel, I figured, okay. I didn't know if it was gonna be Eruption quite yet. Still wasn't sure. But, see, the only problem is that my whole team is actually, like, surprisingly slow. Like, they're all, like, just barely too slow. So, I'm gonna resist a Flamethrower, which is good, and I can get the Thunder Wave on him. Just in time to let him meet an Aqua Tail. See what that does. Oh, good. That's good damage right there. Not bad. Okay. Alright, I'm all for it. I'm all for it. Let's see. Get another Hyper Potion. We've got a good rhythm going here. We can keep getting one hit in, as long as he just keeps going for the Flamethrower. Ooh, even better. We get a free... Oh, come on. 90 accuracy. Come on, it's still good odds. Come on, man. Aqua Tail. Alright, that's fine. Good, good, good. We got him. We got him. Oh, come on. Come on. Come on, man. Are you serious right now? Michelle Ruff. This is too scary right now. Oh, my lord. Please, please, please. Okay. Oh, God. And his last Pokemon's Magneton. Dude, we might actually have this. Oh, man. Oh, my God. We might actually have this. All right. Synthesis. Go right for Synthesis. Good. We outspeed Magneton. It's gonna go for a Magnet Bomb. Ooh, Thunder Wave. Well played, sir. All right. So that's gonna do very little. Oh, thank God, we've got this in the bag. I can't believe we did that. Oh my God. We are way too lucky, I think. Like, even with healing items, this would have been a really tough battle. But oh my God, we did it. I am so shocked. Dude, I was playing around. I thought I was gonna lose, like, halfway through this fight, and I'm still winning somehow. This is just, like, our miracle team, apparently. Oh my lord, man, come on. Here we go, okay. There. I like that Synthesis, though. Synthesis is just so useful, man. You get it so early in the game, and it can just follow you right through to the end. Just that half HP healing? Oh, God, it comes in handy. I mean, it helps that he's, like, the only... Chikorita is the only Pokemon that really has a reliable recovery like that, which is nice. Really helps with the whole defensive deal. Alright, man. I can't believe we won that. I don't even know what to say to that. I thought I was gonna lose, and, like, I can friggin' go fight... I can go fight, like, a team of, like, Magmar, and, like, I'm done for. But I can take on Dinkles' whole team... with really only four functional Pokemon. anyway. I guess that's just a testament to how much stronger we are now that everyone's, for the most part, fairly well caught up. But, I've gotta cut off this video and, go to work because, you know, that's a thing that exists. So, I guess I'll see you guys. I've got a whole bunch of special videos planned for this coming week. So, I actually won't be talking to you guys face-to-face again until, like, 2 weeks from now. June something. Let me check the calendar, actually. June 2nd will be the next time. I'm gonna take a week to, I did all this stuff ahead of time with these special videos to grant myself some time for, YGPT, and, hopefully finish put together my next list video, so, I'll get that all done. And, did I already save? I don't even friggin' know. I guess I'm, whatever, I haven't been paying attention. I gotta go to work. Peace.